Okay, last time we did the Fourier series, and then we came up with the formula for this, this, and that. And they are all in terms of integrals, right? And if you guys haven't seen that video, be sure you guys go check that out. Well, today, we are going to make this complex. And to do so, look at we have cosine and sine. And we did talk about the complex definition of cosine and sine in the past. And if you guys haven't seen this video, be sure you guys go check that out as well. I will have the links in the description for your convenience. So what we are going to do is, we will just see cosine of nx, this is my theta. I will just put that right here and here, and then we'll replace this with the cosine, and we will do the similar thing for sine, and then we'll continue from there. And in the end, it's going to be really beautiful. You guys will love it. And by the way, if you guys haven't subscribed, be sure you guys do so. Thank you guys so much. My goal is to hit 400,000 subscribers by the end of this year. And thank you guys for your support. We can do it together. Okay, enough talking. Now, let's see. Let's just write down the things that we are not going to touch. So this right here, a zero stays. And this right here, it's the sum as n goes from 1 to infinity. And here we have a n. And then for this, once again, we just put nx and x. Therefore, we are going to have parentheses here. We have e to the I times nx. And we are going to add e to the negative I and then nx, and then divided by 2. So this is pretty much the complex version of cosine of nx. Now, for the second part right here, yes, look at this is also a summation from 1 to infinity. You can put it together in one summation, but it's actually better if you write it down again. So we add the sum as n goes from 1 to infinity. Here we have bn, and to get the sine of nx, well, let's use this, of course. However, this time, I don't like to be on the bottom. So I'm going to just multiply the top and bottom by I to fix that situation. And notice, I times I is just negative 1. So here you have negative 1. So altogether, you are just saying you are multiplying by negative I with the top, pretty much. So right here, I'm going to write this down right here for you guys. This is negative I. Multiply with this, you have negative I e to the I theta, which is nx. So we put down the nx right here. And then negative I times negative becomes positive I. And we will have the e to the negative I nx. And the denominator is still just a 2 because we took care of this on the top earlier already. So we divide it by 2 like that. So this is cool. Now, what can we do next? Well, here we have e to the inx. Likewise, e to the inx. This part has e to the negative inx, and this part has e to the negative inx. We're going to just collect the similar terms, right? So let's see. I'm going to once again write this down because we are not going to touch this yet. So a0. And then here, I will just say we add the sum as n goes from 1 to infinity. And perhaps, let's collect all the terms that has e to the inx first. So that's my target. I will put it down right here, e to the inx. Well, from this part, we know when you multiply an with this, an will be right here, right? So we will have an. And yes, it's over 2. And in fact, right here, it's also over 2, so we can just put it together. And to get the e to the inx from this part, it's actually bn times negative I. Therefore, you will have to have the minus I and then the bn like this. And this right here is like a coefficient for this e to the inx. So that's what we have. Now, we do the similar thing for the e to the negative inx. And as I said, we are going to write down another summation, but still n goes from 1 to infinity. So let's see. This time, my target is to get the e to the negative inx. And from this part, it's an divided by 2. So we will have an, and then, yes, just put it over 2 like that. From this part, we will have bn times I, and then divided by 2. We have the divided by 2 right here already. So we'll just say we add I and then multiply by bn like that. Cool, huh? Now, what can we do next? Well, as we can see here, we have e to the inx, and this right here is e to the negative inx. In fact, I can make this into e to the inx as well, because here we have a summation. All we need to do is rename the index. And to do that, let me just write this down right here for you guys. I'll just put all this right here. So all we are going to do is we will change all the n's right here to negative n. So just kind of change it, and you'll see right here for this part, it's going to be e. And imagine if you put negative n right here for this n, negative times that negative will give you positive. So altogether, you get inx here, which is very nice. And you still have to do the same for the rest of the n's right here. So you put negative n here and here. So right here, you get a sub negative n, and then you add I times b sub negative n, and then divide it by 2. Well, you also have to do the same right here. Originally, n goes from positive 1 to positive infinity. Now you're just negating the n's. In other words, you are going from negative 1 to negative infinity. However, we always write down the smaller number here, right? So in another word, we will say n goes from negative infinity to negative 1. And this right here is so much better, because this and that are the same now. And in fact, we can put this, this, and that into one summation. And this is how. First, look at this right here, which is just like a coefficient for that, right? And we can rename this. And we used a and b n already, so we'll just call this to be cn. And from this, we are talking about c1, c2, c3, and so on, because n goes from positive 1 to positive infinity. Well, here we have this number, a0. Why don't we just go ahead and call this to be c0? Sure, right? And especially if you imagine you have e to the I times 0x. Yes, you can legitimately call this to be c0. And if you come here, yes, we can also call this right here to be cn. And not to be confused that this cn and that cn, even though they look different, the idea is that the n right here goes from positive 1 to positive infinity, but the n right here goes from negative infinity to negative 1. So right here, you're talking about c positive 1, c positive 2, and so on. This right here, you're talking about c negative 1 and c negative 2, and so on. C positive 1 can be different than c negative 1, right? That's the idea. You're just calling this to be the sequence. In fact, c positive 1 and c negative 1, they are the complex conjugate. Why? Because here you have the minus, here you have the plus. So c positive n and c of the negative whatever n, you know, they're complex conjugate. Anyway, now we're going to just write this down into one summation. And here we go. We will have the sum as n going from negative infinity, including 0, and then up to positive infinity. So let me just put this down right here. And for the coefficients, it's just all c's. So we just put on cn right here. And we multiply this by e to the inx, like that. Well, this is it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is how the complex version of the Fourier series looks like. So let me just write down f of x on the left-hand side right here for you guys. Well, we are not quite done yet, because we should still figure out a formula for cn, right? Otherwise, this is just the look. We cannot do any computations. Now, this is how we are going to figure out the cn. It's very similar to the situations that we were trying to figure out a and bn. First, let me just write this down. What we'll do first is that we will multiply both sides by e to the negative imx. And you might be wondering, why do we do the negative? It's so that we can almost end up with the complex conjugate. And why do we use m instead of n? It's because similar reason than the situation from the previous video. To figure out an, we multiply everything by cosine mx. And you will see we actually end up with a complex conjugate real soon right here, right? But OK, we multiply e to the imx on both sides. And we will, of course, integrate them. And we will integrate this from negative pi to pi, just like from the previous video. And don't forget to put on the dx right here. Otherwise, people will complain. Well, assuming this converges, the sum of the integrals is the integral of the sums, right? So we can just say, if you integrate this, we can just put the integral inside, and that will be just a constant multiple. So we'll just look at the integral right here, negative pi to positive pi, and you have the dx right here. So we will focus on this integral, right? So look at this part, because this is to be done, and you are trying to figure out this right here. This right here, you have two possibilities. I will write this down. This is equal to, either you have 0 if n and m are different, right? And in fact, I have another video that works out the computation for this. If n and m are different, you end up with 0. And the only time that you end up with a non-zero number is 2 pi when n is equal to m. And of course, when n and m are equal, here we had inx. And this is e to the negative inx. That's why it's the complex conjugate. So that's very cool. And here's the deal. From here, you only get one term, namely 2 pi times cm, because that's the time when n is equal to m, right? So you can just perhaps write this down right here. Just put down this right here. So all this, all this is equal to 2 pi times cm, right? Well, here I use m, here I use m, but we are using n. So we can just change the m and m to n's. And we divide 2 pi on both sides. So let me just write this down for you guys. Cn, okay? It's equal to, put the 2 pi here. You get 1 over 2 pi. And you would integrate this from negative pi to positive pi. And you have the function, of course, f of x times e to the negative inx, because once again, you put the n back, dx. So yes, you still have to work on integral to get the coefficients. But this right here, you may like it a lot more than the sine cosine ones. You may like it more than the real ones, because I know that's what you guys like. Anyway, so this right here is it. Whew, took me a while to record it, so please give me a like. And leave a comment down below and let me know if you guys have any questions for any of this. Anyway, as always, that's it.